Ray with one eye. That's me, Ray. Ray Seven. So today I'm coming to you with a video for. So I was going into this room and I found this doll that I got at a secondhand store. I think it was maybe 3 weeks ago, maybe a month ago. And I cut her hair and everything. And she had some kind of bangs, but twisted onto kind of like a unicorn thing. I feel like I've just been toy hunting and it's time for me to do some customizing because the weather's gonna be good next week and that's the last week that I'm gonna be by myself at work, so I'm trying to use as much time as I can to do some stuff. I also got some feathers for Seven's wings that I want to make. What else? I thought I'd record a little bit because it's gonna be a process and many videos and I'm gonna put in one. What else? Oh, I'm boiling some water because I'm gonna take her ass out. I hope I can take her ass out because I haven't seen no one take her ass out. This doll's ass out, so I'm thinking the water is gonna be able to take it out with hot water. But I don't know, so we'll see how that goes. I will tell you guys the process. So I want to customize her like the Korra fashion, the Japanese, I think it's Japanese fashion. I was watching the documentary. I don't know if it's on Netflix or is it on YouTube, but I watched, I think it might have been on YouTube because I think it was in the box when I was watching it. A couple of months ago. And when I saw her, I'm like, let me try to do something because I already had her on the box right there. This is the same one. And I want to try something with her. I was inspired by that fashion, the Chinese fashion, and I've seen some people doing some dolls lately on YouTube, some repaints and stuff. So I wanted to try my version of doing that. I also wanted to, we have a lot of ponies, lots of ponies. I found more ponies cleaning Trina's room up. I gotta clean them up, I told her I would clean them up for her. Just got a little baby pony. And I wanna, one of these ponies is gonna go with her, I don't know which one it would be. And some other things that I wanna put on to, this is super dirty, that I want to add with her. So I'm thinking about taking Trina to Claire, so we're going to get some things to go with this doll, and we'll see you in a minute, or in the next video, which will be one video. I'm back already. So her eyes do come out with hot water, so what I did, I boiled some water, and put her hair like this, hey. And it got soft enough, this is very soft now, where they come out. Look at the hair I have, Trina. Can you see? And there's some very cheap eyes.
Are they soft?
No. But, because I want to clean up, erase her face. Oh, I'm excited now. And then I'm going to erase her face. Once I erase that, I'm going to put the eyes back in. And then I will what? Then I will repaint her. Oh, I'm excited. So, yep. And her hairstyle, I'm gonna keep it like that, but I'm excited. Raise her face now. Her eyes are big. What I'm planning to do, I'm gonna spray her. And maybe outline the eyes. I don't know. Because the eyes got to go back in before I can repaint her. Because if I repaint her and pop this back in, I don't know if that hot water is going to damage her face. I'll probably have to put them back in before I start doing any kind of repaint. I don't like her eyelashes. So I might take the eyelashes out and put her, give her new eyelashes around here. I want some like pink, colorful ones. I don't know where I can, maybe I have to go somewhere where I can get pink, colorful ones. But look at her face. She looks like one of those other pull-up doll. I'm very excited. Fortunately, it's too cold right now. Look at her. It's what, snow? It's cold on 6 o'clock, but I went outside and even though it's sunny, it's a little cold to spray her. But tomorrow is supposed to, this whole week is supposed to be up in the 70s. some that spray when I get to work early in the morning. Spray it. I got all the dolls that I want to work on, but I'm going to do her first, and then sometime I'll get back to 7, because 7 needs some wings, and yeah, I'm excited. So I guess that's it for this video. I was going to do a whole video, but when I repaint her stuff. Then what I'm going to do, I'm just going to upload this video today, and I'm going to put them all together first. Because I hate editing. It's just, I should have made it all one video, stop and go, but I didn't. So, there you go. But it's a small video anyway, so it'll be less time to put together. But let me stop talking. I'm excited. I want to make her some clothes eventually, and I think I got the shoes for her already. Her legs are kind of weird. But I'm excited, so I will see you on the next one. Bye, guys. I'm back. I thought I was done with my video, but I'm not. So, I put the eyes back in. Now she looks like she's been traumatized. Oh my god, look at that face. She looks traumatized. Poor baby. So I did the same method. Hot water. Hot boiling water. We dip her hair back in. And this time, because I didn't boil enough water. So you have to boil enough water. Because the pan that I use is like this big and with this much water. So I had to go all the way like this because I'm slow sometimes. So, but it worked. I pushed them back in and they were not in the right way, but I'm going to show you something. So as you see, I took her eyelashes. Not eyelashes. I always say eyelashes. I don't know why. Her eyebrows off because I just hate these eyebrows. I want to give some different eyebrows, colorful eyebrows. Hopefully everything goes accordingly. So where her eyelashes were, there's like a little gap, like a little cut in there. So what I did while it's hot, while everything is warm, you stick a knife right there. It has to have to be a sharp knife or something can fit in there. And you can move the eyes around to position them the way you want them to stay, like the way they were. I wanted them to be a little bit different, but I'm like, no, just put it back the way it were. I wanted them like looking to the side a bit. I think that looks good. That's what she looks surprised. But yeah, so when it's warm, when the vinyl is warm and you push them in, I think I might have, yeah, you have to be careful when you push them back in because it takes a minute to put them back in. But once in there, you can just move them around to see position where you, how you want them. And I'm very excited what I'm going to do next. Tomorrow when I get to work, I'm going to cover this with tape, with the painter's tape. I have someone, I think this will work. Yeah, that's going to work. It's masking tape. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cover it and then make sure it just covers the eye. And then I sprayed it. And I'm going to leave it like that, and then I'm going to repaint her and see how it comes out. Because I actually did something like this before with my LPS Black. That's how I put it. I took her eyes off, and that's how I moved them around. And I covered the, actually I didn't cover the eyes. That's the reason I put them back in, because when I did my Blythe, my mini Blythe, long, long time ago, when I put them back in, and it was already repainted, when you put it back in, the paint and the repaint comes off, and that's all kinds of weird stuff. So I don't want that to happen to this one. Look at her. She's so scary. You're going to be fine. And I'm probably redo her hair differently. So hopefully by next week, I can have her done because I want to make her own clothes like I said. And I might just have the time this week. But this is it, you guys. Thank you for watching and subscribing. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.